PH color-changing makeup, also known as mood makeup, has been around for decades, but a new crop of shapeshifters or shade shifters has emerged.
Yeah, lifestyle and beauty expert Mickey Williams joins us once more to show us how they can work and break down whether it's hype or whether it's legit. And I feel like everything in the 90s is coming back, so this makes sense.
Absolutely. And I think what's really important about this is, like, it's the brands have gotten a little bit smarter to realize that, like, hey, you know, we can add a little bit of pigment here or we could add a lot. And I think buildable is the new thing that we see that we all love, whether it's a foundation or mood makeup. Or,
So Anissa, our producer from Spotlight, is our guest today, our model today. And so we're trying out, what are we doing on Anissa?
So let's just talk about how it works.
Okay.
Do you want to do that?
Yeah,
okay,
sure.
So first of all, how it works is it's kind of like litmus paper, you know? So what it is we all have like a pH. Our skin has a pH, which is like 4.5 to 5.5 for most people. And then we take a weak acid and we add it to that and it'll change to colors. But these are really more or less invisible pigments that are built into here.
Okay.
So what happens is most of them are in a berry range, and then once your body meets this, you know, color or this formula, then it shade shifts to what's right for you.
Okay.
We don't see a huge range, but it does really show up. And some of the products have just created these gorgeous bases that they, you know, they kind of like hold all the pigment in. So one of the ones that stood out to me, first of all, Givenchy came out with this black lipstick. I'm gonna put it on for you right now so you can just kind of see what's gonna happen. It goes in now.
It doesn't go on
black,
that's for sure.
It has a little bit of a tint there of like a maroon. And by the end of the segment, you're gonna see how much it builds up onto my lips, okay?
Okay.
And also something to consider, what you put on your cheeks and what you put on your lips are gonna come out different colors because the saliva actually changes it.
The pH.
On your,
Okay.
All right, so first off, when you're looking for a mood makeup or anything like this, they come in pans or they can come in sticks. It's all about the base. So if you're looking for a product that's drier, this is great if you have very oily skin.
Yeah, okay, that's me.
But if you want, and then something like this product, which we found, and you were familiar with this, there's one called Youthphoria. We tested Youthphoria against like the competitor brands, and we found no difference.
Okay, okay.
So this one was like, I think $9.99 on Amazon.
Oh, amazing.
Okay.
All right, this is a blush oil. So would you like for me to put a little bit on you guys?
Yeah.
You see, it's changing different colors. This has a wonderful little pop of color to it. And the way that I say about this is, you know, if you're gonna be putting this on, make sure that you have a brush handy.
I'll say, you do have to move quickly?
Yes, and wherever you touch is gonna light up.
Right.
But when it's in the base of a balm or an oil, you can kind of spread it.
Okay.
You know?
Okay.
But when you're working with a cake, it can be a little bit more difficult.
Okay.
So I just wanna show you, this is just a nice, beautiful, buildable color. But then let's say we're gonna go into something like this, right? This is another one that has the black base there. You see it?
Yeah.
You see?
Yeah.
If we applied this, it would have more of a color on you.
Okay.
So let's see.
That's a pretty color on you.
Isn't it? I think that, you know, when you're looking for these products, look for products that have a really great payoff.
Oh, look.
And definitely test it on your hand beforehand. And
so you
like
can't
that.
Go wrong with the color because it's matching your pH.
And everybody is kind of a universal berry in some shade.
Okay.
And so they keep these there. Some of these do have undertones of coral.
Okay.
But then I found this one, and I don't know who wants to try this one over there. I can do it to myself, too.
What's that?
But I'll show you on your cheek here.
On your cheek, okay.
It's such a creamy.
Wow.
Look at that.
You see?
Yeah.
So you're just going to start playing around with these and finding out what is going to work with you. But when they're at a price point of $9.99 or $10.99, and you can really have fun with this, right?
And look, it's
so
not
even it out.
It's not,
I don't
want to
look like that.
It's not pink. I just want to show everybody. It's not really pink when it's
orange.
No, and if you were to use a clean brush, it would. And I like this one because it has a little shimmer. This one's by Lottie London. It has a little shimmer underneath it, but it does have that dewy base.
Yeah.
Okay.
And if you were to use a brush, that pigment wouldn't shade shift on top there.
Okay.
You know
okay.
what I mean?
Yeah,
so
yes.
you could actually just wipe it off and then.
Yeah. That's so
I love these products.
And then look
They're
at the
fun.
Color
it's
on
so much
me.
Different.
And then put it on you. Okay.
It's different on everybody.
Oh,
isn't that fun?
Look at that difference.
Oh, wow. That's
it's
cool.
very different depending upon. And now you see my lips.
Yeah.
Everything is very buildable. So that's why it's kind of fun. I love these two because they really do last a long time. They stay on. And if you're just looking for a very natural flush, it's just a beautiful product.
Yeah, that
right?
looks great on Anissa.
Can you use it on her eyes?
Oh, yeah, you can use it everywhere.
Cool.
Lottie London is a very clean product. Obviously, you want to check your bases. These are actually, I found these on Amazon. They say that they all come to a different shade. These were the lightest ones that I could find.
Okay.
That really and truly just had such little payoff.
Okay.
But they were a beautiful product. They have an aloe base. It's all about what kind of base you want, right? Like, which base?
That's a pretty, like, frosty pink. I like this.
Yeah, they come out very different.
Yeah.
So you can layer, you can do whatever you like.
Yeah, that's shiny. Oh, wow. We can have fun.
Pretty?
I was playing makeup with your girlfriend.
Yeah. Yeah. We're like in a slumber party.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Yes. Like,
can I get your
also
fun? Yeah. Oh, this is so fun.
Cool. I like the buildable aspect, right?
The buildable, so you don't come out looking crazy, looking like Mimi from Drew Carey.
Right.
You know?
And that even went on pretty bright on your face, but it seems to have muted itself a little bit.
And actually, that's what I always want to point out when you're doing any kind of stick blush or using any kind of bristle brush that's a little bit firm. You're always going to flush naturally, so wait about 30 seconds, and then you're going to really see the true color of what you're doing. I love when I see people blending their brush over and over and over and over again, you're trying to get rid of it, and you're like, you're just adding like a flush to it, so give it a second.
Things you learn. Mickey, thank you so much. We appreciate it. Right. Mickey Williams Glam on YouTube. Check her out. She's got more tutorials for you there.
All right. Thanks, Anissa.
Thanks, Anissa.
All right.